Welcome back to Little Brother. The time is 6:14. In just a few moments, we'll be finding out what crazy horse David Schneider... Crazy horse! ..got up to in the diary room and how he feels about bedding down with John James and Josie. But first, it's time for the news. George, don't forget those cards.
So, at 9:04 last night, the Cougar and the Mole were discussing the looming eviction this Friday. During their chat, Mario told of his curse and the unfortunate fate the Cougar may face.
Joe, I don't want you to be evicted.
Anyone that you seem to befriend gets dashed out. Haven't you noticed that?
Sorry, I've given you the kiss of death.
Poor Nathan. Poor Iffy.
Sunshine. Ben.
So I know, yeah, Ben. I know my hours are numbered, never mind days.
Step away from the Mole, Joe. Now, later that evening at 11:20, Sammy Pepper discovered that his hats had done a vanishing act. Naturally, he didn't take it lying down.
Where are my hats?
Samuel, get them back in the morning.
No, I want them back now.
Don't worry about
no,
it.
I want
if you
them
don't
now.
Make a fuss, you'll get them, I'm sure.
No, I want them now, though.
Who's took them?
I don't know. There's gonna be trouble.
Just after midnight, it was revealed that John James was, in fact, the sneaky hat stealer. So, after Hatgate came to a close, Mr. Pepper went from being loud to louder as he went on a coffee-induced prank rampage lasting nearly 2 hours. He went from popping balloons over sleeping housemates to putting chili in the toothpaste. Let's have a look at his best bits.
Hyper diaper. Oh, I've had 4 cups of coffee.
What's Sam doing? He's getting more and more hyped up, he is.
I know, he needs to go to bed.
He is the most annoying person ever to have lived.
He won't be having another coffee for a while. To see more of the Pepper Prankster, head over to channel4.com/Big Brother. Now, before the break, Nick made some rather inappropriate rhyming slang. We apologise for that. But now it's time for a very special diary room chat with David Schneider speaking to Big Brother. Hello, Big Brother.
Hello, David. How are you?
Oh, not very happy. My belly is so not full of love. I miss my family. I don't even have a family. It's like I'm just being ignored the whole time.
Feel very down, Corinne. I think I might walk. Corinne, aren't you going to say, no, don't walk, everyone likes you, I like you, and then you nominate me and then I get upset and... Corinne? Hello? Look, JJ naked. Corinne? Oh,
it's really doing my head in sharing a bed with John James and Josie.
Just not pleasant. And that one time I tried to have a laugh and went into the garden naked, I just frightened everyone.
Oh my god,
it's huge.
It's not gonna hurt you.
That was huge, Joel. That was the size of an arm.
I tried to be positive. Like Josie said, when you're down, just think of that poor woman who had her face ripped off by a chimpanzee. Well, I like to think of that even worse story of a man who had a ridiculous beard drawn on his face by a chimpanzee.
And how are you getting on with your fellow housemates?
Well, at least Sam Pepper's calmed down since his bit of honesty in the diary room the other day.
I'm doing that for the cameras. I'm going to nominate me.
Do you see any romance in the house, apart from John James and Josie?
Well, there's JJ.
And Corin?
No, and the sofa. I mean, I hope they're taking precautions, and just look at them. I mean, get a room with a sofa in it. Well, that reminds me, Andrew's done this week's shopping list. There we go. 40 watermelons. And fags, of course.
The diary room door is now open.
Nominations. Should be all right. No problems, I've been all right so far, eh? Right, bye.
Yeah!
Oh, well. There's always save and replace.
Oh, I love David Schneider. And yes, indeed, there is always save and replace. Now, we all know that however much Big Brother producers cast, task and design the house, they will never keep everybody happy. But when it comes to voicing opinions, online Big Brother forums have proved themselves to have not only the biggest but also the harshest fans. So to get some insight into the anonymous world of the Big Brother forum, please welcome reality TV editor for Digital Spy Alex Fletcher, yay! Digital Spy forum member Lisa Robinson, and former housemate and active BB forum poster girl, Laura! Yay! How are you, Laura?
We're very well, very good.
Right, let's get down to the nitty-gritty. First of all, why has Big Brother captured your users for such a long time?
Because it's the biggest TV show that everyone talks about. It's the old cliche about being in the office, being at work, and people wanting something to talk about. And we've got 370,000 users on our site and who go on the forums and talk about stuff, 7 million people who read it, and yeah, it's just the biggest show for people to talk about. It generates more chat than anything else.
But a lot of their posts are quite negative, aren't they?
Yeah, they are negative, but I prefer to think of it as being passion that's maybe overflowing to criticise, because they want their show, they love their show so much.
I think there are a lot of posts which aren't just negative about the show maybe, but really personal. And personal about people's like attitudes and their appearances. And I think those are completely unnecessary because you don't even know that person. All you've seen is them on
a TV. It's a show about personalities. It's about people.
Exactly, but not about looks. So
do they come back for more? Because they really do love it.
Yeah, they always come back.
And they're passionate about it.
But it's
like, they feel like this is their place to voice it.
Yeah, this is their place. It's their community. It's their pub. It's where they go every night to talk about...
It's their pub.
It is. It's their pub. It's like going to, England fans will always come back to support the England team, no matter how rubbish they are. And no matter how angry they are that their favourite housemate's gone, they'll always come back to the forums and have a chat and talk about it and, and vent their frustrations. But that's just because they love it so much.
OK, now, you're a forum user, aren't you, Lisa?
Yeah.
And there's a lot of conspiracy theories on there, and there's a lot of paranoia about how much Big Brother is fixed.
Yeah.
Do they really believe this?
Yes, yeah. I think a lot of people do.
What is it about the show that they think...?
They think that the producers have favourites. They think they edit people to win. Certain people they give good edits, certain people they give bad edits.
But that would take so much more time than it does to make the show as it is already.
That's what the housemates do and say. It's not the producers haven't been saying, you say this, you do this. They've chosen to do it.
Yeah.
So...
Well, a lot of people think it's the edits. That's why they're happy that you can. There's some sort of form of live feed this year.
Yeah.
Because you can actually see what people are like. Because sometimes the edits are a little bit,
Yeah.
Someone's always going to come out better on an edit because you can't literally show everything on the highlight show.
And you've got 24 hours to squeeze into an hour, so you've got to go with the main stories, really.
Yeah, and some of the people on these forums do literally watch it pretty much around the clock. So
they have their own opinion.
Yeah, so
anyway.
They have their different opinion. They saw the rest of they saw the other 23 hours, and that's why I think they get a little bit frustrated sometimes.
Okay, well, we've got a quote from creative director Mr. Phil Edgar Jones about Big Brother conspiracies and the chosen ones. He says, I don't care who wins. We chose all the housemates, and what happens after that is unpredictable. It's ludicrous to think that we would give ourselves the headache of trying to get someone to win it. It would be nonsense. You agree?
I really agree with that, yeah, definitely.
It's a little bit boring, though, isn't it? It'd be nice to think there was some conspiracies going on behind the scenes.
Yeah, people enjoy it.
It'd be nice to think it was all a great big fix.
Is that how they're kind of living out their lives? It's all fixed! Come on!
Yeah, it makes it a little bit more interesting. It's another thing to talk about.
Yeah. Okay, there's also a lot of negative comments about what is wrong with the show. So do you think the users on there think that they could make a better show than what we're making now?
I think they do, yeah. But then again, I think if they had that sort of power... they're such a diverse different sort of people in the house that they would probably moan anyway, even if they chose them. And, like, say, for example, there's quite a few people on there that have auditioned sort of several
like
times.
Like, you've auditioned? Yeah. How many times have you auditioned?
About five. And
get her in.
And, and I think they'd be really mean, because a lot of people, they sort of say, you know, yeah, I've auditioned, blah, blah. And I think they'd be really mean if they had that power and they wouldn't let those people go in.
OK, now, Laura, you actively post on BBC.
Yeah.
You did so before you went in the house.
Yeah.
And you continue to do it now.
Yeah.
So as someone that's seen it from both sides, have you changed your opinion at all?
I definitely have. I think it's very easy, you know, even if you've been for the audition process, which is completely nothing like what it is when you go into the house, you post on it, you just see what, you know, you don't actually know what it's like to have the cameras around you, to know you're in a film setting. The pressure in there is unbelievable. So you could say, yeah, it's easy, or why did they walk, or it's being really boring, why is she crying all the time? But until you're actually in there, you just don't know what it's going to be like.
But nobody likes a walker, Laura, do we?
No! I didn't, you know, looking back on it, you know, I don't regret walking, because the way I felt in the house, I didn't want to be there anymore. I gave my place to somebody else who's far more entertaining than I would have been since I wasn't being myself.
And we all do love something.
Yeah.
What creates the best threads on there and the biggest threads?
Either the Get George Lamb in the House thread. I think it's Blimey Isn't Emma Willis Fit.
I know what they say about me on there. It's not
and anything to do with Sam Pepper right now is very hot.
Who is favourite to win on the site?
I think at the moment there's a divide between the Sam Pepperites and then the John James and Jersey people who love a good showmance.
Who have loved them from the beginning and want the romance. Well, it's good to know that, because now we can go away, we can re-edit the show, and we can fix it like we do with everything else.
Yes,
what do you reckon?
Yeah,
yay!
Might as well.
Guys, thank you so much. I am joking, by the way, before I
earlier in our poll, we asked you, is Corinne a game player? 55% of you said, yes, she is, everybody!
It is a game!
That's it for today.
Should.
Thanks to all of our guests. Join us tomorrow for Eviction Friday, when we'll be joined by comedian Rob Deering and the lovely Davina.
Make sure you catch the main show tonight on Channel 4 at 10 o'clock. And as always, for all the latest goings-on, head to the website. Have a lovely evening. What are you doing tonight, George?
I'm going to go home and fix Big Brother.
Are you?
Yeah.
Should we go and do it together?
I'm going to go and meet Phil. We're going to just sit round, just fix the whole thing.
We'll put you in at the end and we'll fix it for you.
I can win. I'm going to win Big Brother.
And then his dream will be fulfilled.